Secondly, can you please pray for us?
Yes, sir. Good morning, everybody. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we want to thank you for waking us up today. There are a lot of people out there that are not waking up to see this day. We thank you for your blessing, your protection, and preservation of our lives. We pray, oh Lord, for that, Father, that what we're doing today in front, in your honor, is accepted in your sight. We thank you for the blessing of whatever it is that we're going to encounter today, because we know that you're going to be with us. Thank you for everything that you're doing, everything that you're going to do, and everything that you've done in the past. We exalt you, Father. We glorify you for who you are. We ascribe, O Lord, Father, to your majesty. We pray, O Lord, Father, that your blessing would always go with us and your presence would always go before us in everything that we do. We glorify your name, Father. Thank you, love. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you do and what you are in our lives. We thank you, Lord, and glorify you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank God so much for this morning. We are all welcome into God's presence again. You know, this is a happy time when we all show up together before our Father. And he shows up also to meet his children. So this morning, we know that God is here, the Holy Spirit is here, and Jesus Christ is here. Now let us go into our time of worship, where we bring our worship unto our God.
that again. Hallelujah. Every voice in this room. Yes, you have. So we give you high praise and we say, hallelujah. You have won it all for me.
Light in the darkness, my God, that is who. worshiping you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you.
Amen, amen. We thank God so much for this morning. We give him all the glory, all the honor and praise for that time of worship. We will go into our time of prayer, and this morning, Brother George Mensah will be leading us in the time of prayer. Let us welcome him.
Amen, 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 amen. He is the answer to it all. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. This morning, we'll be making declarations of faith. We'll be making the declarations of faith. So each person will be making declaration healing and health.
Give me 1 second here.
Sure.
Please. My file got closed, so just reopening it. In a second, show more. Please go ahead.
So our first declaration, Father, thank you for today. I thank you because you have given me a mouth and wisdom, that as I say it, I will have it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So let us make our declaration in faith. Oh, Heavenly Father, you have created me perfect in your own image, Lord. I thank you, you have given me wisdom, that as I say it, I shall have it. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. The word in Luke 1:15 says, for I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, this morning I declare that you have given, because you have given me a mouth and wisdom, that as I say it, Lord, I will have it. I will have it all, because you have it and you have given it to me and you have given me wisdom. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Now, declaration number two. The Lord is my source and my shield. The Lord is my shelter in time of trouble. The Lord is my very present help. You are my strength and comfort. Let us pray and let us declare. Oh, Father, you are my source and my shield. Father, you are my shelter in times of trouble. Father, you are my very present help. Father, you are my strength and comfort. The word in 3 John 1:2 says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy, Psalm 61:3, for thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from my enemy. Oh Lord, you are my source and my shield. You are my shelter in times of trouble. I know that when trouble comes, I can find shelter in you, oh Lord. You are my present help. Father, you are my strength and my comfort. In all things, in all, in Jesus' mighty name, amen. Now, declaration number three. Declaration number three says, I prosper financially. I'm a tither and a giver. Therefore, I believe the windows of heaven are opened. Hallelujah. Pouring out blessings in my life. Every financial need of my life is met, and there is no lack. My God supplies all my needs according to his riches in glory. Let us pray and let us declare. Oh, our Lord and Master Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I make these declarations today that I prosper financially. I am a tither and I give. Therefore, I believe the windows of heaven are open today, this morning, and is pouring out all blessings in my life. Every financial need of my life is met in Jesus' mighty name, and there is no lack. My God, my Lord, my Master, Savior, my King of Kings, riches and glory in Jesus' mighty name. The word in 3 John 1, 2 says, Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. Again, apply all your needs according to his riches in glory in Jesus' mighty name. Oh Lord, I declare today that I prosper financially. I'm a tither and a giver as well. Therefore, I believe that the windows are open this morning and they are pouring out all blessings in my life. Every financial need, I will have no financial need, Lord, because every financial need in my life is met and there is no lack. My God, you supply all my needs according to your riches in glory in Jesus' mighty name, I declare, Lord. Amen. Amen. Now, declarations number 4. Father, I confess prosperity in my life today. I prosper in spirit, soul, and body. I prosper spiritually, socially, and financially. All that I lay my hands to do prospers in Jesus' name. Let us declare, let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this morning I confess prosperity in my life today. I prosper spirit, soul, and body. I prosper spiritually, socially, and financially. All that I lay my hands on, Lord, everything that I touch prospers. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare. You know, your word in Psalm 1:3 says, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, this morning I come to you and I, in all faith, Lord, the power of the mighty name of Jesus, I confess prosperity in my life today. I prosper in all aspects of my spirit, soul, and body, Lord. I prosper spiritually, socially, and financially. And all that I lay my hands on, everything that I touch, Lord, I prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now, declaration number 5. I am redeemed from the curse of sickness and death. Jesus bore my sickness in his own body, and by his stripes I am healed. Every organ and tissue in me functions perfectly. I forbid sickness and disease in my body in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Let us pray. Let us declare. Oh, Father. Heavenly Father, my Lord and my Master, my Savior, Jesus Christ, and by that power that is in the name of Jesus, I declare this morning that I am redeemed from the curse of sickness and death. The Jesus who bore my sickness in his own body, and by his stripes, Lord, I am healed. Every organ and every tissue in me functions perfectly. I forbid sickness. I forbid disease in my body, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. The word in Galatians 3:13 says, Christ hath redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. Again, Jeremiah 31:11 says, for the Lord hath redeemed Jacob and ransomed him from the hand of him that was stronger than he. Oh, Father, in all faith, in filled with faith and by the power of the mighty name of Jesus, I declare that I am redeemed from the curse of sickness and death this morning. That Jesus, you bore my sickness in your own body, and by your stripes I am healed. Every organ and every tissue in me functions perfectly just like you designed it when I was born, Lord. I forbid sickness. I forbid disease in my body in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, amen. Now, declaration number six. Father, you sent your word and healed and delivered me from all afflictions. Your word is medicine and healing to all my flesh. Your word says that by his stripes I was healed. I stand on all these today, walking in sound health. Let us pray, let us declare in faith, Lord. Father, I stand before your throne this morning. I walk in your grace. I walk strongly in your throne of grace this morning. And Father, by the mighty name of Jesus, I make declarations today, and I declare that you sent your word and it healed and delivered me from all afflictions. Your word is medicine and is healing to all my flesh. Your word says that by his stripes, by the stripes of Jesus, I am healed, and I stand on all these words today. I stand on all these words, and I walk in sound health in Jesus' mighty name. The word in Isaiah 53:5 says, but he was wounded for our transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus this morning, I declare that your word that you sent to us has healed and delivered me from all afflictions. Your word is medicine and is healing to all my flesh. Your word says that by his stripes I was healed, and I know that I am healed of all diseases and all afflictions this morning, Lord. I stand on all of these words, and I walk in sound health in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, amen. And finally, a final declaration. I receive the health and cure of God in my body. I walk in total restoration of health as promised by my Father, Jehovah Rapha, my covenant healer. Oh, let us pray and let us declare. Oh, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus this morning, I declare that I receive the health and cure of God in my body. I walk in total restoration of health as promised by my Father, Jehovah Rapha, my covenant leader, my covenant healer, in Jesus' mighty name. Now the word in Jeremiah 33:6 says, behold, I will bring you health and cure, and I will cure them and reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. Again, Jeremiah 33:17 says, for I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, says the Lord, because they call thee an outcast, saying, this is Zion, whom no man seeketh after. Oh, Father, your word pronounces this. Your word declares it. And so in faith, filled with faith this morning, and by the power of that of God in my body, I walk in total restoration of health as promised by my Father, Jehovah Rapha, my covenant healer. Lord, I receive and I declare total health and restoration in my body today. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed and we have declared, and he has delivered. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen, amen. We thank God so much for this time of declarations. You know, declarations is a powerful way of prayer. You're making declarations by faith. And as we have made these declarations, we believe that these declarations have entered into the ears of God, and God has delivered them. It is confirmed by him. So we thank God so much for that. We'll go into our word this morning, and this morning we'll be focusing on Proverbs chapter 30, and Sister Claire will be reading for us. Let's welcome Sister Claire. And so how we will do it, Sister Claire, we'll go from verse 1 to 10. And then, you know, I would say verse 1 to 9 to begin with, verse 1 to 9, and then I'll take over and then we'll keep going that way.
Well, good morning, family. This is Proverbs 30. The word of Agur, the son of Jake, even the prophecy, the man spoke unto Ithiel, even unto Ithiel and Ucal. Surely I am more brutish than any man, and have not the understanding of a man. I neither learned wisdom, nor have the knowledge of the holy. Who hath ascended up into heaven, or descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fist? Who hath bound the waters in a garment? Who hath established all the ends of the earth? What is his name, and what is his son's name, if thou canst tell? Every word of God is pure. He is a shield unto them who put their trust in him. Add thou not unto his words, lest he reprove thee, and thou be found a liar. Two things have I required of thee. Deny me them not before I die. Remove far from me vanity and lies. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Feed me with food convenient for me, lest I be full and deny thee and say, who is the Lord? Or lest I be poor and steal and take the name of my Lord and my God in vain.
Amen. Amen. So, seriously, going through Proverbs 30, I decided to go to the Message translation to get more context, of the words of, you know, Agua, the son of Jake. He was a prophet, right? And so this is prophetic words of wisdom, which is different from the normal words of wisdom that Solomon will speak. This is wisdom that he had received in prophecy. And, you know, so going through, you know, as we've been talking about the book of the Proverbs, you know, these are nuggets of wisdom dropping up on us. These are wisdom. Sometimes, you know, they don't follow the same context, right? It's not, you know, the regular books of the Bible, which are more storylines. But these are wisdoms that, you know, had come upon this prophet and he has delivered them. And from verse 1, you know, the Message translation say, the skeptic swore there is no God. You know, he said that the skeptic swore that there is no God. No God. I can do anything I want. I am more animal than human. So-called human intelligence escaped me. You know, this is, and we all see people who do that, right? We know people who are skeptics, right? They say, hey, there is no God. You know, I can do everything that I, you know, everything that I need to do, I can do it myself. You know, I can depend on my own strength. And, you know, when you work with these people, sometimes they can convince you that there is no God. They will point you to people who are atheists and people who are not Christians who have become successful in our world today and say, oh, there is no God. From verse 3 going downwards, he says, you know, I flung the wisdom. He says, I neither learned wisdom nor have the knowledge of the holy. You know, he said, I flung, I see no evidence of a holy God. The Message translation says, I see no evidence of a holy God. Has anyone ever seen anyone climb into heaven and take charge and grab their wings and control them? So he's basically building a case like the atheists, and as I'm saying, and people who are not Christians, how they will convince or how they will build their own human intelligence or their own, you know, argument to say there is no God, you know, who has gone to heaven and come down, you know, who has been able to grab their wings and control them. What this prophet is telling us that there will be people like these. You know, they will turn human wisdom around. And when you hang out with these people, we know what happens. You know, they can challenge our faith. And Jesus Christ said, watch those that we walk with. Right. And if you keep going down from verse 5, it says, the believer replied, every promise of God proves true. So he's saying, hey, you may have an atheist or somebody who doesn't believe in God saying these things, but the believer, you and I replied from verse 5, he says, every word of God is pure. He's a shield unto them that put their trust in him. And I think that is our response to some of these things when people say, oh, there is no God. Have you ever seen God before? You know, we said every word of God is pure. Take the Bible and explain the Bible to people. Point the word of God to them. And let them understand that for us, our results is different. They may have a different result, but our result is different. He says, the believer replied, every promise of God proves true. He protects everyone who runs to him for help. So don't second guess him. Don't second guess God. He might take you to tax and show up your lies. You know, let us not second guess God. His word is his word. You know, the Bible never changes. Some people will say, oh, the Bible was written by a man. Oh, the Bible is not written by God. And oh, the Bible is just a history book. And it's, you know, no, tell them, no, the Bible is the word of God. He says every word of God is pure. And he holds it. And tell them your testimonies also. Let's tell them our testimonies. And from verse 7 to 9, he says, and they prayed, God, I am asking for two things before I die. Don't refuse me. You know, so here, there's somebody who's talking about, you know, how he can live a whole life. He said, give me enough food to live, neither too much nor too little. If I am too full, I might get independent, saying, God, who needs him? If I am poor, I might steal and dishonor the name of my God. So what he's saying is that, God, just keep me perfect. Help me. Don't give me too much that I'll not be able to, you know, that will take me away from you. But keep me. Make sure that I have enough, you know, and I am well taken. You see, the Bible says the blessing of the Lord adds no sorrow. You know, it makes us rich and adds no sorrow. We'll continue from verse 10. I think we'll go from verse 10 all the way to verse 17. Verse 10 to 17.
Okay. Accuse not a servant unto his master, lest he curse thee and thou be found guilty. There is a generation that curses their father and doth not bless their mother. There is a generation that are pure in their own eyes and yet is not washed from their filthiness. There is a generation, oh, how lofty are their eyes, and their eyelids are lifted up. There is a generation whose teeth are as swords and their jaw teeth as knives, to devour the poor from off the earth and the needy from among men. The whoreslash hath two daughters, crying, give, give. There are three things that are never satisfied, yea, four things. Say not, it is enough. The grave and the barren womb, the earth that is not filled with water, and the fire that saith not, it is enough. The eye that mocketh at his father and despised to obey his mother, and the ravens of the valley shall pick it out, and the young eagles shall eat it.
Amen. Amen. So here he's talking about the generational changes, right? He's talking about generations. And today we see that, you know, throughout society, you know, we look at them and say, oh, wow, the generations coming up is disrespectful. The new generation, they want everything, you know, the new generation. And so you can see, like, there's a generation, he's talking about generational decay, right? Of ethics and of, you know, and of you know, of righteousness and of, you know, good behavior, right? So that there's a generation that curses their father and does not bless their mother. There's a generation that are pure in their own eyes and yet is not washed from their filthiness. There's a generation, oh, how lofty are their eyes and their eyelids are lifted. You know, he's talking about that generational changes. You know, today we're talking about the Gen X and the Gen Y and, you know, and the Gen Z and all these generations, right? And he's talking about, you know, how these things happen, right? And he's coming back, you know, when you go to the message and say, don't blow the whistle on your fellow workers. Verse 10, accuse not a servant unto his master. And then from there, he comes back down talking about, don't curse your father or fail to bless your mother. Don't imagine yourself to be quite presentable when you haven't had a bath in weeks. He says, don't be stuck up and don't think you are better than everyone else. You know, it's talking about pride, right? Thinking that we are more important than other people. You know, don't think that you are better than your father who gave birth to you. You know, there are some of us, you know, we are more educated than our parents. You know, we are more polished than our ancestry, right? And there is that temptation to look down upon the generations before you, or to look down upon your father. Say, do not curse your father or fail to bless your mother. Verse 14 says, don't be greedy. Verse 14, don't be greedy and don't be merciless and cruel. So there's a generation whose teeth are as swords and their jaw teeth as knives, to devour the poor from off the earth and the needy from among men. You know, the horse leech has two daughters crying, give me, give me. You know, he's talking about that that new generation, or the risk of moral decay is what he's talking about here, which we see in our society. You know, there are things that when we were young, you couldn't even think about, but today it exists today, you know, and he's talking about how do we watch about these things? How do we watch about these things? And verse 16, he says, the grave and the barren womb, the earth that is not filled with water, and the fire that says not, it is enough. If you go to the message, it said, a freeloader has two daughters. The one name is Give Me, and the other is Give Me. He said, three things are never satisfied. Three things are never satisfied. They are never satisfied. No, there are four that never say, that's enough. Thank you. You know, he says, there is hell, there's a barren womb, there's a parched land, and there's a forest fire. He said, these things are not satisfying, and we can relate to them. You know, when we are not content with what we have, right? We it's easy for people like that to get into sinful behaviors and find themselves going to hell. You know, there's a barren womb. You know, there's people who are just not satisfied with life. You know, whatever they have, they still have that emptiness, because all they think about is, give me more and give me more and give me more, right? And they say they are never satisfied. They say three things are never satisfied. And talk about parched land. A parched land is a land that cannot produce anything. A parched land is, as we know, you know, it's like a clay land or a desert land. You can't plant anything in it and it cannot produce. You can put every seed in it, but it never grow. And that is a person who is never satisfied. And I think that is something that we all need to watch out for. The Bible says contentment is gainful. Contentment is gainful. We need to be content with life. Contentment is gainful. And it's saying, and the other one is saying, it's forest fire, if you read from the Message translation. So these things, these four things, you know, are a result of a never satisfied person. There is the risk of hell, there's the barren womb, there is a parched land, and there's forest fire. We know what a forest fire does. It doesn't produce anything good, it just destroys. You know, when there is fire in the forest, all it does is just destroying. And what he's saying here is, you know, a house that is never satisfied leads to destructive life. You know, they are just like a forest fire. They are like a patched land. You can't plant anything on them. They are like a forest fire. They destroy. They are like a barren womb. You know, no seed can grow and bear fruit. They are fruitless. And they have the risk of hell. And these are very important things that the words of wisdom is coming to us on. All right, we'll go from verse 18 to verse 33.
Okay. There be three things which are too wonderful for me, yea, four, which I know not. The way of an eagle in the air, the way of a serpent upon a rock, the way of a ship in the midst of the sea, and the way of a man with a maid. Such is the way of an adulterous woman. She eateth and wipeth her mouth and saith, I have done no wickedness. For three things the earth is disquieted, and for four which it cannot bear. For a servant when he reigneth, and a fool when he is filled with meat. For an odious woman when she is married, and an handmaid that is heir to her mistress. There be four things which are little upon the earth, but they are exceeding wise. The ants are a people not strong, yet they prepare their meat in the summer. The conies are but a feeble folk, yet make they their houses in the rocks. The locusts have no king, yet they go forth, all of them, by bands. The spider take hold with her hands and is in the king's palaces. There be three things which go well, yea, four are comely in going. A lion, which is strongest among beasts, and turneth not away for any. A greyhound, and a goat also, and a king, against whom there is no rising up. If thou hast done foolishly in lifting up thyself, or if thou hast thought evil, lay thine hand upon thy mouth. Surely the churning of milk bringeth forth butter, and the wringing of the nose bringeth forth blood. So the force of wrath bring forth strife.
Amen. Amen again. So here again, we can see these are nuggets of wisdom. This is a prophetic declaration of wisdom, right? You know, the prophet is looking around, he's dropping all these nuggets of wisdom. He's looking at things that are bad, things that you know, that we should frown upon, and things that are exceedingly wise. He's making these comparisons, right? Verse 21, he talks about He talks about things that are disquieted, you know, things that, you know, are no good, right? And he's talking about, you know, when a servant reigns and a fool is filled with meat and an odious woman is married, so he talks about all these and he talks about what are the wise things that are exceedingly wise. Right, and some of those wise things referring to an ant. We all know how an ant is. You know, they are very little creatures, but they prepare for the future. They prepare for the summer. Think about the locust. You know, they have no kings, but they can get into a field and destroy the whole field. These little creatures. Now, there's a spider who can get into a king's palace. You know, the king's palace has the most, the biggest security, but they can get in there. You know, he's just dropping nuggets of wisdom. And I think as we read these things, right, we look at ourselves in the mirror and say, you know, how does this relate to me? You know, it is time for us to go before the Lord in our personal time of prayer. And I think this is time where we say, Lord, help me to look in the mirror. Show me my blind spots. Help me to be wise. Help me. Show me the things that I need to do, you know, to be wise. Show me, you know, open my eyes to see. Give me wisdom. You know, there are all these things that I may fall short of. You know, all of us can find ourselves somewhere. You know, is it pride? Is it being disrespectful? You know, are we allowing sin into our lives? Are we be comfortable with sin? You know, it is time for us to go before the Lord, you know, and let us do that, and then we'll come back together again. Amen. Amen. Once again, we thank God so much for this time. We give him all the praise, all the honor, and all the adoration. We thank him for these words of wisdom and this nourishment. We'll call our sister Winifred to give us the announcements and the closing blessings.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We thank God for his instructions unto us to get wisdom, to get understanding. Father, may your spirit of wisdom continue to impact our lives, making godly decisions. Help us to align ourselves with you so we can start enjoying all of it that you have reserved unto us. Father, as your children go today, let your Holy Spirit continue to transform them to be work in progress until perfection. Do something new in their lives, Lord, never to be the same again. Now I pray, release unto them the key of the house of David, so that every step that they take lead into unusual favors and great testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. Please always check your emails as Pastor Tuji sends out emails to some of us to carry out some assignments. So watch out for those emails as they come to you and always acknowledge them. Acknowledge them, reply, so that it's not passed on to someone else. Let us remember it is our duty to keep adding men to this morning devotion so they can be blessed. And in so doing, we shall be rewarded. The program runs Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. Mountain Time. So we will be back again tomorrow, same time, 5 a.m. Mountain Time. Let us go, be the church, be kingdom citizens on earth. Now let's share the goodness together. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Jesus is Lord.